you up either way.
Nah, you start. I'll start. You start.
Don't you start.
Okay. Don't you start.
We're live.
We're live. She started without us. Welcome to another week in the Breezeway. Good to see everybody. Wow, another
Yeah, time. Another good podcast here.
Thanks. Good to see these guys. Anyways, my friend, this is Beebs. This week's guest.
That's Kevin Young and Dean Austin.
Good to see you guys again. Little jam session we had in Beep Shop too.
It was so.
It was nice to bring that hot little guitar picker with you. That's
I was kind of hoping he'd show up tonight.
Was it? He's a treat. He's a treat for us. That fellow. You guys are one lucky.
No.
Yes.
So
we are. Very
So, what's new with you guys?
It's winter time.
It's winter time.
Yeah.
So you're just about ready to
go? We're ready to go.
Yeah, I know everybody that you talk to in the music aids just
waiting. Come on, summer. Get the trailer out. Let's get the jamborees here.
So I heard you're going to start tonight off with Merle Haggard.
I believe so.
Yeah? Yeah. My favorite.
That's what Boss says.
Yeah. I know he's a George fan over there. But
I'm pretty damn close. I think I got some John Prine coming up for you today.
Yeah, I know. I love to
like that.
I might have to stick around and do a couple after.
That would be fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. We can do that.
I already expected a late night out of you guys anyways. I did. After that jam session we had, this one could end up into a...
This could last a while. Well,
we'll let you get started.
All right.
Okay.
Wish a buckle was still silver, fat, a trailer strong. Back before Elvis, before the Vietnam War came along. Before the Beatles sang yesterday, when a man still worked and he still worked. All the free life behind us now. How few times will your work for the good? I'm rolling downhill by a snowfall, headed for the hood. No kind of chance for a flag or a liberty bell. Wish a Ford in the Chevy still last 10 years like it should. Best of the free life behind us now. Not a good time for the old girl for the girl. Still cold, the joint, a bad place to be. Back before Nixon lied to us all on TV. Before microwave ovens, the girl would still cook and chop wood. The best of the free life behind us now. Good times for the old world for good. I'm rolling downhill like a snowball headed for hell. No kind of chance for the flag or the liberty bell. Wish a poor man to Chevy still last 10 years like he should. Best on the green line behind us now. Not a good time to really overhaul you. out rolling downhill like snow long headed over. Stand up on the flag and the song ring the liberty bell. Let's make a Ford and a Chevy. Still has 10 years left, sure. Best of the free life is still yet to come. Good times ain't over for good.
Thank you. Here comes the voice again. You gonna start this time?
Sure.
You better start this time.
Good old Merle Haggard. He had come with those Ford and Chevy last 10 years.
Yeah, really.
Good voice. I just
got
the back there. We got a set list.
Oh, nothing wrong with that.
We got a great big long set list because, like you said, too many long nights.
Sometimes you don't know how long the show's going to go. I know that we've got to cut it back in the summertime for Greg for an hour.
That, we'll
so
get
we
around.
Might as well play with
it. We get better every time, don't we?
I'm glad we got here before the summertime.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, we're hoping to keep this little spot because they've got a beautiful patio back.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
I
saw that.
Summertime, yeah, so yeah. We're working on a few other spots.
And the water always tastes better in the summertime.
It certainly does.
Kevin's got one picked out here for it. What do you got mine now?
How's the burger, Fred?
A little
good.
Brooks and Dunn.
Brooks and Dunn.
Brooks and Dunn. Looks like fun.
Sun goes down on my side. Long time feeling comes to my door.
Budweiser? Sure.
Blue. Run down bar across the railroad. Table for two, way in the back. I said, it's on. Think of living here. I spend most every night beneath the light of a neon moon. If you lose your one. Running wild and free. Close my eyes and sometimes see you in the shadows. It's no fear. No telling how many tears I sat here and cried. How many lies that I've lied, telling my poor heart. She'll come back someday. Oh, but I'll be alright as long as there's light from a neon moon. If you lose your one and only, don't wait through here for the lonely. Watch your broken dreams dancing and out of the beams of the neon. Jukebox played on, drink by drink. Words of every sad song seem to say what I think heard inside of me. Ain't never gonna end. Oh, but I'll be alright as long as there's light from any neon moon. If you lose your one. Broken dreams dancing out of the beams of a knee.
two heading to that side.
Great Herman's, fellas.
Thanks, man.
Very good.
Yes, very nice.
Thank you.
I'm going to check out that blurry screen. It seems to come in and might be blurry. Could be my eyes, so.
I think mine, I ain't even drinking tonight, so I'm seeing perfect.
Good lad.
I know.
So how did this little duo start up, other than did you meet through getting together, Rambling Fever?
Yeah.
Actually, it was a funny story. Kevin phoned me one Friday night and he said, I got a wedding to play tomorrow. He said, I got a guitar player, I got a drummer, but I don't want to play.
Okay, I'll bring the bill over, okay?
He said, do you want to sit in? Sure. So we practiced that afternoon, went and played the gig that night, and we've been playing together ever since. Right on. Yeah.
That was
fun.
Good
phone call then.
It was a great phone call. Yeah, it was an awesome phone call. Kind of formed Rambling Fever right there.
Yeah. Boom. Yeah, it was good. That's a real quick thing.
Have you got any up and coming things with Rambling Fever?
Yeah, we're next weekend this Saturday, I guess it is. We're at Desirano Legion. Four till eight.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
And then the 25th, we're at Walt's Sugar Shack for the Maple and County from 2:00 to 2:30, I think it is. And then Henron from 8 to 12.
Yeah.
Getting
busy. It's a busy day. Next Saturday.
For sure.
Well, it's good to be busy, though.
That's right. Yeah.
And they can get a hold of you. I know you got a Facebook page.
We have a Facebook page, and we have a website that's pretty much ready. It's coming in the next week or two.
Good. And I hope to see you.
Yeah, thanks to Luke for doing that, by the way. Thanks, man. Gene's son, Luke.
When you go, Luke?
And I hope to see some when you get this up and running, get some videos.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
I always check everybody's videos on there. Like, I see Tyler Cochran's in the house.
Yeah.
Nice to have you again, Tyler. I check all his videos. I check all of them.
Yeah, I see him more than I see Ken Pope.
Well, he's like Ken Pope.
Yeah, he's my brother.
He's coming up on the show, too.
Yeah, Tyler's coming up, but I can't remember the date. When is that? May? No. 28th of March? Oh, yeah, that's Uncle Brownie's birthday. How did I forget that? And are you guys playing at Napanee Jamboree this year as well?
Not sure.
I'm there.
I think Kevin is, yes.
Yeah, I'm there. No. The band didn't get hired this year.
That happens. I run a backyard bash and I got so many people to choose from, pick from, and everything else, and there might be a date change on that. Might not be June 3rd, it might be June 10th. So, and the only reason I'm changing is because I might want to change it.
You might want to change it.
Yeah.
And you're entitled.
Yes. Yeah. Yep. I think I am. So, he's ready to
come on. Yeah, Kevin's going to show us what his class project was.
Yeah, this next song, actually, I'm in college, actually, going through for a social service worker. Everybody from the college is watching me. So, last semester, I got to do a school project, an assignment, that you can learn something new. And my something new was to learn how to pick a bluegrass song. So, Mr. Brad Harpel, who's in our band, and you all know him, he actually taught me how to play the song. Kind of got it, not as good as him, but
fortunate.
Show me this regular burger with fries and gravy.
Sunshine one more time. When, oh, when will it be over? When will I let it burn down? And when I die, dear Lord, in heaven, I trust in my soul beneath that cold dark ground. I still breathe, my poor brother. I still hear my dear old mother cry. Late at night, came and told her he lost his life down in the Grand Deer Mine. When, oh, when will it be over? When will I lay his birds down? And when I die, dear Lord, in heaven, you see my soul beneath that cold dark ground. Mm-hmm. and love, my poker chill, no plow mule, shovel and day hoe. When, oh, when will it be all over? When will I let it burn down? And when I die, dear Lord in heaven, please take my soul beneath that cold dark ground. When I die, dear Lord in heaven, please take my soul beneath that cold dark ground.
Oh, that's fun.
Hard to sit still through that one. Yeah. Great job.
Did you tap both feet? Doit Yoakum. You did. Doit did that, right?
Yes.
I haven't heard that in a long time.
I always try to just tap this one to the right.
Is that how it works?
I try. Okay. I try to keep working on this time.
You got a new CD you're working on here, Sam?
Yeah, the band, I'm actually in the midst of writing tunes, so we're going to play a couple tonight.
I was going to ask about this songwriting thing, because I like the originals.
Yeah, I've been writing a lot with Dan Washburn.
We had Dan on the show,
too. Hey, Dan, if you're watching. He's an amazing songwriter, singer, musician. But he's been helping me out writing songs. He's an amazing songwriter. So.
You got your own studio as well?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got that going. I'm glad to see it.
Oh, we're looking forward to it. When do you think you get heard?
We're hoping by mid-summer, anyway.
Okay. Well, look forward to it. We'll get you back on when you get her out. And,
that would be nice.
CD release.
Absolutely.
CD
release.
Yep, we'll do that.
Yeah, for sure. It's always fun getting
together. We'll plan the best for that one.
What do you got for us next?
I think we're going to do a John Pine for you.
Oh, right on. Right on.
And apartments in the city. Me and Loretta Light living there. It's been years since the kids are grown. A life of their own left us alone. John and Linda, they live in Omaha. Joe is somewhere on the road. We lost baby in the Korean War, and I still don't know what for. It don't matter anymore. Oh, the old tree just grows stronger, and old rivers go wider every day. And old people just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello. Much more. She sits and stares through the back door screen. All the news just repeats itself like some forgotten dream that we both see. Someday I'll go in. Call up when needed. We work together in the factory. What will I say if he asks what's new?
Say nothing, what's with you?
Ain't nothing much with you. You know
tall trees just grow stronger, and old rivers grow wider every day. And old people, they just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello in there. If you're walking down the street sometime, you spot some hollow in ancient eyes, please don't just pass some lights there, as if you didn't care, just say hello in there, hello. Send that one out to my buddy Joe Petrari down in the States. He's another big Crying fan.
What a great songwriter he is, eh? Amazing.
Crying, one of the best.
Yep.
And when Christofferson says that, you know it's got to be true.
Yeah.
That was a good songwriter.
Yeah. Well, I'd like everybody to hit the share button out there in Facebook land.
To share, like, love.
That little share button's just on the right hand side. Just click that. And I hope that the feed's coming through good out there. If anybody wants to, can. Hey, Mike, take a request. Why don't you shoot one up?
I don't know.
No.
Great song. Love you, Bennett. And my grandson's watching. No, sorry.
You get three strikes.
That's two strikes? Well, I'll tell you what, you give me a little bit and we might be able to do that.
Have you got a couple? How about a couple? You got a couple for us? We got a couple.
I know what you're doing.
I'm going to go check out the sound, how far back it goes.
Unfortunately, you're walking out when we're going to do an original.
No, I can't.
Yeah, this one actually was wrote by myself and Mr. Dan Washburn. The story behind this song is the new country that's out there, everybody complains about it. And, you know, it's not country, it is country, blah, blah, blah. I'm of the type that if they're recording music, it's music. And, you know,
it's country
crossed with rap. But, right, so I wanted to write a song to kind of that effect, but to actually, you know, say both sides of this story. So, if this one's called Gonna Play It Like Merle.
So whatever turns your crank, floats your boat. If the music turns you on, well, that's all she wrote. So don't diss my kind of country till you get a world. But as for me and my house, I'm gonna play like bird. These days on the radio, we got the guys asking the girls, crank up, let's go. I'm up in my truck, we're on the angel's tread. Well, the girls that I know slap me up the side of the head. So whatever turns your crank, you float your boat. If the music turns you on, well, that's all she knows. till you give it a whirl. But after me and my house, I'm gonna play it like mine. Please don't get me wrong, I'm not judging you. But if the writing don't get better, I'm gonna lose my cool. So whatever turns your crank, float your boat. If the music turns you on, that's all she wrote. Then don't kiss my kind of country till you give it a whirl. But as for me at my house, I'm gonna play it like bird. As for me at my house, I'm gonna play it like bird.
You want to buy that, do you?
Yeah, I would love that.
I'll tell you what, we'll sell it to you.
It should be played on the radio, for sure.
That was a nice piece of writing.
Danny's always been, I've known Danny for a lot of years, and always been an awesome writer.
He's great.
Yeah.
You go there and you have an idea. Dan, I kind of like this. What do you think? I have a thought. And he just goes with it.
Yeah. Let's do this.
And his laptop playing, too.
Yeah.
I jammed a lot with his father, Elwood.
Okay,
how I didn't know his dad. He was a gold medal player, and he was part of the Burnley Triangle, is what we call it back then. There was three of us left in the triangle at Burnley. I lost in the Burnley Triangle a few times with Elwood.
Yeah.
Another original?
No.
We got
another original coming up with it.
No, how about Vince Gill, though?
You?
Love Vince.
Yep.
Sure.
Yeah, we'll do two. Look at us.
After all these years. Look at us, after all that we've been through. Look at us, still leaning on each other. If you want to see how true love speaks, then just look at us. Look at you, still pretty as a picture. Look at me, still crazy over you. Look at us, still believing in forever. If they wanna see how true love should be, they'll just look at us. Chances are
I don't think we've ever done this one in public.
Never. No. Can I have that coffee?
Maybe there's a reason for that. We'll find out right now.
Just don't throw any food. If you do, make it French fries, because maybe I have some.
She's still hungry.
Is that your daughter? No, she's my mom. That's funny.
I Buck Owens did this one.
That's what I just said. I did the same thing when I was like, yeah.
I don't remember.
I'll give you love, that's above. Hand me on the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. I'll give you love, that's above. Hand me on the call of love, and love something that money can't buy. Well, a poor boy's chance with a pretty girl glance is sometimes baby give. Oh, I've got no money, if you be my honey, here's what I'll offer you. I'll give you love, that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. I'll give you love, that's above and beyond the call of love, and love something that money can't buy. Well, I met by chance, and I knew at a glance that I found my destiny. Now I want to carry you off and marry you if you will agree. That I'll give you love, that's above and beyond the call of love, never ever make you cry. Yeah, I'll give you love, that's above and beyond the call of love, and love something that money can't buy. Yeah, love something that money can't buy.
They're dancing in the streets.
Perfect. Can't beat old Bob Owens.
Downtown.
Oh,
over.
Can. Yeah, can you hear it outside?
Huh?
Oh, they're dancing on the sidewalk.
That's what I said. Yeah, a bunch dancing in the streets.
Yeah, absolutely.
It was him. It was out there.
He was out there dancing.
Well,
he kept his clothes on anyway this time.
Dancing, but
I just say he kept his clothes on this time.
Well, this guitar. I don't think I've ever played one before until.
I tell you what. He misses this guitar.
Oh, dirt?
No, I don't.
Yeah.
Yeah, he misses this guitar. He won't say anything about it, but he does.
But I have a Martin and a Taylor.
And a Taylor, yeah. Both of them, he's going out of tune, so.
They sell them tuned, though.
They do?
Yeah.
Mine came in a box tuned.
Yeah. And they drink it.
No, it's different.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, different sound.
Boulder Creek. Actually, a really nice guitar. Never had a guitar like that. But every sound, man, wherever I played that thing, they just love it. They
like the
The Martin's okay. That's a running thing between him and I. You got to pick each other's guitars.
Oh yeah. Well, you have to do that.
I do that a little bit with him.
And of course, Brad. Of course, he plays the telly, and it's out of tune after every song. Just because of
that. Have you seen that guy bend strings?
I know. Yeah.
The strings are going, ow!
That's right,
Brad. Hi, Brad.
That's got to come naturally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I've worked up guitar, and it's just...
I've never seen somebody as young as him play the way he does.
Yeah, he's just young.
I've seen older guys that can play
You know, doing this Breezeway, we had the opportunity of meeting some real fine young guitar players.
Yeah.
Young Clayton Marks, unbelievable. Yeah. Kyle Renton.
Oh, Kyle Renton, yeah. That's right.
And there's very few players, just a story about him. He was bending strings on the Breezeway, you know, and I'm playing, and we now we got him going, and he busts a string.
Yeah.
Some players, if they bust a string, you just finish the song gracefully and play. But knowing that he's a young fella, knowing what I know about music, I turn around to him and I said, there you go. So I cut him loose in the second lead break with five strings.
Yeah. He was just fine, right?
He was just fine. And I'm like, well, yeah, he's got it. He's got it. Because I normally wouldn't do it. Right, yeah. To my lead player, whatever.
Yeah.
Just gracefully get out of the song, go change the string, somebody say, you know what? There you go.
Yeah. Go ahead.
What do you got coming up, boys?
More Dwight.
Dwight, yeah.
All right.
That only hurt just a little bit.
Yeah.
It won't hurt when I fall down from this bar stool. It won't hurt when I stumble in the street. It won't hurt because of the whiskey is free. Even whiskey cannot ease your hurt. It won't hurt when I fall down from this bar stool. It won't hurt when I stumble in the street. It won't hurt come over the whiskey if it's free. Even whiskey cannot ease your hurt. Every sign to get up on is the wrong side of the bed.
If it weren't so expensive, I'd wish I was a dead. I'm unhappy. Unhappy, unhappy. You have no complaints. You are what you are, and you ain't what you ain't. So listen up, Buster, and listen up, good. Stop wishing for bad luck and knocking on the door. When I was a child, my family would travel down western Kentucky, where my parents were born. There's a backwards old town that's often remembered so many times that my memories are born. And Daddy won't you take me back to Newberry County, down by the Green River where paradise lives. Oh, I'm sorry, my son, but it's too late to ask Mr. Peabody's coal train's called it away. Well, sometimes we travel right down the Green River, the abandoned old prison down by Avery Hill. There the air smelled like snakes, we'd shoot with our pistols. The empty pop bottles was all we would give. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lives. Oh, I'm sorry, my son, but it's too late to ask me. Mr. Peabody's coal train's all here today. When I let my ashes flow down the Green River, let my soul roll on up to the Rochester Dam. I'll be halfway to heaven with paradise waiting, just 5 miles away from wherever I am. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lays. I'm sorry, my son, but it's too late to ask Mr. Peabody's coal train's all the way. Signed, Dear Abby.
Thank you. I can so. We will get to that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Jill, are you done?
Thank you.
That was good for sitting up on the request.
Yeah.
That is
in front of your own ones.
My favorite, Mr. Peabody's coal train.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's got a lot.
See, Peabody's company went broke, right? Just recently.
Really? Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Never knew. The mining company is kaput.
Whoa.
Yeah.
He's a John Prime's listening kind of guy.
He's very deep.
Yep. I'm a story kind of song. Tom T
and Jerry Jeff Walker and that crew. That's right in there. Steve Goodman.
Yeah. Must be. I don't know, like I said, I don't know too many of Steve Goodman. I probably know
Prime and Goodman co-wrote a lot.
Oh, did they?
You never even called me by my name.
Down
the boat.
Good team.
John Prine and Steve Goodman.
That would have made them a little bit money.
Imagine. Except John told Steve, don't put my name on that because I don't think it's going to be any good.
I seen David Allen Cole. Were you at that show with David Allen Cole, Molson Frankenberry?
No.
I was there. Not that one. I know we were at here at the Hank Williams Jr.
Didn't know we were there at the same time.
I knew I was there.
No, I can't even hardly remember the ride home.
The beer gardens were sold out.
Yeah?
Why does that not surprise me, Pete?
I was a little bit wilder than... Before we go any farther, I'm going to say hello to the wife there today. She has to stay home because my mother-in-law is sick, so she's looking after her. So. And I want to wish her... Tomorrow will be 20 years. Me and Joe will have our first date, March 8th. It was my nan's birthday. That's how I remember that as well. So happy anniversary, dear, and I'll see you when I get home. Love you.
We won't keep it.
I got to cut it off or I'll cry.
Happy anniversary, Joe.
Yeah. Congrats. All for our first date. I even surprised I remember. I've been all the times I've been to Molson Park, I wonder.
You ever get up to that event?
Oh, yeah. Just once.
Say again.
Just once. It was enough.
Yep. Once was enough.
Once was enough.
What do we got? What do we got coming up?
Well, it's kind of funny because I was over at Kevin's the other night and I said, dude, do you know any Everly Brothers? He said, well, no. And I said, well, we do now.
Right on. On, Phil.
I was going to say, because a lot of this stuff isn't Ramblin' Fever's. There's a couple, though.
But that's why we're doing this, is because there's a lot of this older stuff that him and I really like to do.
I'm only, this is a silly question, but Highway 40 Blues, has he taught you the licks on that yet?
You know, he's tried, but I just get confused after the first couple notes.
He cut loose on Highway 40 Blues. Sorry to bring this lad up, but I'm sure
he does. Bring him up all you want.
He's amazing, but when he did Highway 40 Blues, he kind of looked back and... I know where he got it from, though, that Highway 40 Blues. I seen Steve Patico do it.
Exactly.
There's quite a resemblance in that.
Just about every lick he's got is picked up from Steve.
Could you imagine getting off the bus, walking home from school, and on the front porch is Mr. Steve Patico playing, and you just go up and sit down and wave to play with him?
I'll tell you what, I saw Brad when he was 15, sitting on the couch in their place, Steve Patico sitting beside him. Both of them with acoustic guitars. And they were literally trading licks back and forth. And Brad was keeping up. And it was like, there's a young man that's not intimidated by one of the best guitar players around. And he's going to go far. And that was like 6 years ago or 7 years ago. Look at him now.
Humble,
sure.
Too. Humble, yeah. Humble boy.
Oh, great kid.
Yes,
great.
Unbelievable. Is this, this doesn't have to be, I can see this. Yes. Yeah. One of my,
yes, it does.
Are you going for the high end of the?
Well,
we don't know yet.
We don't know yet. Whatever carries us.
Just all you do is lean back a little bit and go for the high note. That's the guy said, I'll be waiting for it. Sorry, I know all about it. Not that I get it. No,
I know my
one of us will get it. Yeah.
I know my mom's actually listening tonight, so this one's going out to mom and dad.
Hey, love you.
Oh, love you.
And yeah, that's
mom
it.
And dad and Bennett.
Don't worry about me. It's all over now. I'll manage somehow. Love can't be explained. It can't be controlled. One day it's warm, next day it's cold. Don't pity me. It might happen. Oh, 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 love, kiss me one time. I'll understand. Don't worry about you. Sweet, sweet, sweet love. I want you to be as happy as I when you love me. I'll never forget you, your sweet memory. It's all over now.
Foot there, the diabetes. So, Terry, if you're watching, hope you get feeling better. Yeah. See you over the summer. Beautiful song by Marty there.
Beautiful.
Yeah, my dad seen Marty Rogers down in Salem, Ohio, actually, down there.
Singing or racing?
No, he was singing. That's about 19.
He's a good driver.
Two or something, yeah. Yes.
I was a good driver.
Yeah.
Yeah, you were a good driver. You drove something a little bigger than him.
Phone tree. Well, Lee is ringing. Oh, well, his name is Conley, and it was one of their other.
Oh,
yeah.
Can you do that?
Oh, God.
No. You do any Tom and Tom?
No, but you know what? Mention that.
You should bring that up.
I did tell you.
Oh, yeah.
Yesterday was 4 years for Tom passing away.
Yeah.
Great Canadian legend there, and I will miss him.
Yeah,
Bud the Spud.
But yeah, the boy from Skinner's Pines. And another big load of potatoes.
You probably got some people that follow the Breezeway down that way.
Oh, there's quite a few down that way, yeah.
I would think so.
Kathleen Pittman down there, this man, she probably watched the things. Hi, Kathleen, she's one of our faithful followers. I never got to see Stomp and Tom. I wish I had a couple of chances, and it was one of those things, you know, I'll see him again somewhere down the road, and then I never did.
I seen him at the Havelock Jamboree, and he was the only entertainer on that stage. I went quite a few years in a row, probably 18, and never seen anybody except beer from the crowd.
Except him.
He wasn't just getting one.
You weren't there the night we played there.
He's a good band member because he was catching more for the boys in the band too. He was thinking of the boys.
You obviously weren't there.
I've had that experience.
He had a lot of beer bottles at this stage that night. I don't even drink.
I had that experience once. I was last year. We went up. Saw friends of ours, Dan and Shell, for watching. Up in Nunavut.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
wow, yeah. Cool.
We flew up there and they said, the only payment I want is for you to go to the local bar. And there isn't many. But went there and played two tunes for all the people. That's how they show their appreciation, is they buy you beer. I had a stage full.
They had to carry Kevin home.
Yeah.
Awesome. We tried to do that, but Fred can only carry two of them.
Oh, no.
I can't figure that out. You got 10 fingers. One in each one, you got four in each hand.
Well, I could just say that. You're going to get them to explain that, aren't you?
Yeah.
I just finished reading the Whalen book there, and when they, Whalen sent the Black Cherry, and said, Dad, they keep throwing beer on the stage. The Whalen went out himself. I said, he said, listen, I said, I really appreciate the beer, but we can't drink them that fast. So they stopped throwing them, and the son said, how'd you do that? He goes, they weren't really throwing them at you. They're throwing them to you. You're supposed to catch them.
What have you got there?
John Pine.
Oh, again, beautiful.
By request. We were going to do it anyway, but this fellow requested it. So. Sam Stone came home to his wife and family after serving in the conflict overseas. And the time that he'd served had shattered all his nerves, left a little shrapnel in his knee. But the morphine eased the pain, and the grass grew around his brain, gave him all the confidence he lacked. With a purple heart and a monkey on his back, there's a hole in Daddy's arm where all the money goes. Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pictures have big ears, don't stop, count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone's welcome home didn't last too long. He went to work when he spent his last night. And Sammy took to stealing when he got that empty feeling. For $100 habit without overtime. But the gold rolled through his veins like a thousand railroad trains. And eased his mind in the hours that he chose. Plows kids ran around wearing other people's clothes. There's a hole in Danny's arm where all the money goes. Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears,
Don't stop to count the years. Sweet song never lasts too long on broken radios. Sam Stone was alone when he popped his last balloon. Hyman Walswell sitting in a chair. Well, they played his last request, and the room smelled just like death, with an overdose covers in the air. But life had lost its fun, there was nothing to be done. The trade his house that he bought on the GI Bill. Or flag Drake passing on a local hero's hill. There's a hole in Danny's arm where all the money goes. Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pictures have big ears. Don't stop, count the years. Sweet songs never last too long. Broken radios.
Thank you.
I do love that acoustic stuff. That's off the beat.
I'm a real early Prime fan. I don't like his later stuff so much. I like the first three albums.
Who did we have on there here do Louise just recently? Because he was in on that. Bonnie Prime and John Prime. Or Johnny. Bonnie Wright.
Great. No, it was.
Surely Diane Baker did that one.
That's right. I did see that.
Aaron Robbins.
Yes.
What do you got? Another one you wrote here?
Oh, yeah, we want to do that one. Sure.
I really like that bird one.
Well, this one I wrote for my lovely wife. We've been together for 30-some years. I met her when I was 16. We got together, and we've been together ever since. And I'm 48 now, so that's quite a long time.
That's a long time, but
jumping.
So you wrote this one for her? It's going to be on the new album?
It certainly is. Can't forget we first met. I always knew you were the one for me. No regret, past the tip. Time has proven we were right. Been through hell and high waters. Little words for the weary. Everyone said, why bother? Heard the mouth, but didn't care. You found the one. Found the one. And that's how love should go when you found the one. Wrong, that's not home. It's where the heart is, you and me. One more chance, one more dance. Who'd have guessed love gets better with time? Been through hell and high water. Little words on the way. And everyone said, why bother? Her gum out, didn't care. You found the one. That's how love should go when you found the one. Found the one. That's how love should go when you found the one.
Awesome job.
That was, again, helping Dan Washburn help write that song.
Yeah. You did that all over the day, both of them.
Yeah, I said, you know, I want to write a song to my wife and, just, you know, just gave him a brief history of us and boom, that's what we come up with. It took us like an hour.
They wrote both of those originals that we did tonight. They both wrote both in the same day. I know.
I don't think we weeks. Get something down.
If I'm by myself, it takes me years. In fact, I've started write one by myself. I'm still not done. That was
about years ago.
Yeah.
Is that one on the next CD?
It's gonna be.
Okay, good. I just wondered because it could have been already recorded too, right?
No, not yet.
Have you got any recordings?
We started. Yeah. Started with a song that me and Mr. James Spurdy wrote.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah. We started that one. But we've got some work to do on it, and then we're going to move on to the next week. Like I said, hopefully maybe mid to end of summer, I'll have the album
done. Any prior CDs? Like, how long have you been at this?
We've got one cover CD with the band, yeah. And then Kevin's got a couple of his own. And I'm working on another one of my own, which is all John Prine covers. It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to that.
Right? Yeah.
Kevin says, so
I'm sure he would. Okay, Weiss, what do you got coming up?
Someday
it go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes.
We got some really cool stuff that the band's doing too. Really wild new stuff that's actually really good. I'm excited for that.
I gotta correct them though, because it's not new stuff.
Well,
it's
new stuff to us.
We don't do anything new.
Music. Okay, let's go over where you guys are gonna be at again. Just to let everybody know where you're gonna be performing.
Next week, or this coming Saturday, we're at the Deseron Legion, 4 till 8.
And that's open?
Open. Come on out to the Deseron Legion.
Go out and check this Ramblin' Fever.
Yeah.
Get out and check these guys out.
And actually, we're really lucky this weekend because we got Richard Ellis coming out and play drums for us this weekend.
Oh, nice.
The drummer from
Not just as Luke. Yeah.
He's been playing with us and doing some stuff over the winter. He's a new dad. Congratulations, you guys.
Yeah, congrats.
Great band.
Yes, absolutely.
So Saturday, where else? You had a couple more.
March 25th, we're at the Sugar Shack.
Walt's Sugar Shack.
Salem Road down to Continental.
Oh, nice.
And we're there from when?
To 12 till 2:30.
Hey, they sold the bar in Continental, I heard.
I did hear that.
Yes, that's true. That's what. It's closed down.
I heard that.
Because it was a live music venue, too. I hate to hear places that are promoting live music close the doors, and it seemed to be busy. So I don't know
Maybe they can redo the place and reopen.
Let's hope for the musicians' sake.
That would be nice, too.
Yeah, March 25th, that night, we're at Kenron Estates
at the Rock Hall.
Yep. 8 till midnight. We're there.
Yep.
And you can also catch us on Facebook, look up Ramblin' Fever, or myself, Kevin Young. I've got my own page, you've got yours.
I think April, I forget the date, but we're back at Cheers again.
Yep, and trying to Cheers again.
So yeah, it's always a fun job.
Go out and see us next week.
Yeah, Rob Hood down there. And
Cheers.
Yeah,
Cheers. And hope to have better Wi-Fi. And if the Wi-Fi was an issue tonight, we'll get it looked after. It's been a lot of a trying thing. Everybody in the place enjoys it, but I'd really like to make it out to everybody on Facebook.
Yeah, it gets frustrating if you lose your signal.
You're not kidding. Well, you got a couple, three more boys?
I think we should.
Stop the neck at the end of this list. I know how the list works, okay?
Well, listen, we got a George Jones fan.
You certainly
We should actually do this. We
don't know this song.
Yeah. This is our first time doing this, so...
Is he allowed to keep a hold of the microphone?
He can if he likes.
I don't even know what song it is.
Imagine a world where walk in a garden where nothing was growing. Stood by a river where nothing was You've seen a picture of me without you. And you've been to heaven with no angels singing. Or a quiet Sunday morning with no church bells ringing. If you walk as the heart of a child breaks into me, you've seen a picture of me without you. You've seen a picture of me without you.
We don't know that song. We actually, we did a live thing on Facebook here a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, I watched some of
that. One of the comments, they requested that song. I said, we should learn it. Why didn't you on this one?
Yeah. So we didn't learn it. We just
sang it. We just sang it.
Okay, first of all, when you're on Facebook and you're watching live feed, there's a little button on your right hand side.
Yeah.
And it's share. Hit that button.
Share.
I might have.
Absolutely, share.
I'll go back and check.
Okay.
Yeah, I gotta
I'm sure you should have seen that.
Yeah,
yeah, it was about a half an hour long.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
It's fun. There's other people. I watch DJ Roth does Wednesday night. John Mary's got a good following on there. He's gonna watch him.
You know, I also found another webpage.
Oh yeah.
And I'm actually a member now. This is kind of cool because you go on there and you can perform anytime, do a show like this. You guys should look into it because people tip tokens and you actually make money.
It's like online busking.
Yeah, it's online busking. Instead of being in the street, you're in your living room or wherever. And you're doing
really?
Yeah, it's actually awesome. It's called streetjelly.com.
You guys have no idea what you might have started.
I got a lot of time to do it.
Street Jelly?
Streetjelly.com. Streetjellyallonewords.com. And then go on, just make a profile, away you go.
Online buster.
Yeah. I'm gonna have Dean come out and do a show.
Oh yeah.
I was on there for a half an hour the other night just to test it out. I made a whole dollar.
I always thought you could play the liquor store.
That was trouble.
Playing in front of the liquor store, you play the same song all day that somebody could bark to.
You know what the problem is with that? The problem with that is it was probably his wife up in the living room.
Yeah.
just to see if it worked.
Yeah.
It
cost you $1.75 because of the fees.
For a dollar, I'll keep him happy. Give it a couple.
Yeah.
Get a nice girl's record. Thank you.
Okay.
I almost fell to touch me just now. Wish I knew which way feel so good, I feel so bad. Don't know what I ought to do. If I could only fly, if I could only fly, I'd bid this place goodbye. Come and be with you. But I can hardly stand. I've got nowhere to run. Another sinking sun. One more lonely night. Wind keeps blowing somewhere. Every day,
things get better somewhere up the way. This dismal thinking on a dismal day. Sad song for us to bear.
Neither one of us, after playing with Brad, we neither one of us will say we're guitar players.
Anybody that's critical.
I'm a bass player. I don't play guitar.
We shy away from doing any picking, especially when Brad's around, because he kind of looks at you. Well, that's very good. That's very good. Keep practicing.
Brad actually said to Kevin, like, oh, that was cute. That was cute.
And he can say that with
And we'll take it.
Yeah, you'll take it.
And we'll take it.
Shut my mouth.
Okay, boys, we got time for a couple more.
Sure.
Packed her up. You got anything up and coming you'd like to?
Oh, I just want to say, Gerald's made a couple requests lately. We got to get the couple there for Gerald. And one he wants to do Nanotrite.
And he
wanted a Steve Earle. We'll get to you eventually there, Gerald. Appreciate the request.
Certainly do.
Other than that, I think that's it. Let's let him rip off a couple more and we'll wrap her up.
Yeah, we're going to sure. We'll let him wrap them once more.
Okay.
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 If you like.
I might have a double water.
You're not going to do that. Huh? Okay.
I'm on the run, the highway is mine.
magic with just your wings. I've run the Lord, spend my life in this. I'd like to settle down, they won't let me. A fugitive must be rolling stone. Down at the road, there's always one more to see.
Dressed up to go away. First time
like seeing a smiling game. He stopped loving her. They placed a ring on his nose and soon they'll carry him away. He stopped loving her.
You know, she came to see him one last time. Oh, we all wondered if she would. And it kept running through my mind. This time, it's over her for good.
He stopped loving her. They placed a wreath upon his door. He stopped loving her today.
I don't know what I was thinking.
I don't either, but let's not ever do that again.
Let's not ever do that again. No.
It was fun, I gotta say, it was fun.
It was funny.
Not for me.
I thought it was funny. But I'll tell you what, I'm glad you corrected me, because I never would have hit a run. I let you keep me with you.
Have you got a story behind this last song, boys? Do
we have a last song? I don't have a last song. Okay, so you pick one. We'll do a last song. And if it ends up being two, then so be it.
Yep.
Yeah.
You might have to write a song called The Last Song. This is the last song I'll ever do.
That's the one. Guess what? It's another Haggard.
Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Can you send me love from where you are? And you make a rainbow shine and far. Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. And you really make a wish come true. You shine for just the chosen few. Is it over? Have I gone too far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Like two ships on the ocean, we drifted apart. You found an island at sea. I'm still adrift with this pain in my heart. Won't you send your sweet love back to me? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Send me love from where you are. Can you make a rainbow shine that far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. On the ocean, you drifted upon. You found an island at sea. I'm still adrift with this pain in my heart. Won't you send your sweet love back to me? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Can you send me love from where you are? Can you make a rainbow shine like far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Wow, that was something else. I kept looking at your hands and going to the sink board you were playing. I had this thing on here.
Aren't they awesome? Those
I love these things, man. That's why I'm not a guitar player.
They got him for bass players.
Did you notice he looked at me to do a lead there, and I knew.
Yeah, I know.
He does that with me, dude. Yeah. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks for having us.
Good seeing you again.
Thanks for having us, man.
Dean, looking forward to doing it again.
If you'd like to play these folks another candy, you're more than welcome. We're going to shut it off there. So until next week in the Breezeway, keep your beer on ice and your stitches handy.
We're poking toads. See you next Tuesday down the Cheers.
We're actually going to try something that we've never done. And it was a request. And if I mess it up, I mess it up. I'll get as much of it in as I can. How's that?
That sounds good.
Farmer and the teacher, the girl and the preacher, riding on the midnight bus bound for Mexico. One was heading for vacation, one for higher education. Two of them were searching for lost souls. That driver never ever saw a stop sign. 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. While there's not four, but heaven only knows. Yes, it's not what you think when you leave this world behind you. What you leave behind you when you go. That farmer left the harvest on many acres. Faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. That teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children. Did her best to give them all a better start. That preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land? As he laid his bloodstained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. While there's not four of them, heaven only knows. Yes, it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. What you leave behind you when you go. That's the story that our preacher told last Sunday. As he held that bloodstained Bible up for all of us to see, to bless the farmer and the teacher and that preacher. I gave this Bible to my mama who read it to me. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. While there's not four of them, now I guess we know. Yes, it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. What you leave behind you when you go. Three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway.
That was crazy.